पॉलीमाइल्जिया रोमेटिका। इट इज़ एन इंफ्लेमेटरी कंडीशन विच इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाई पेन स्टिफनेस इन नेक शोल्डर एंड पेल्विक गर्डल एंड इट इज इट कैन बी एसोसिएटेड विद जॉइंट आर्थराइटिस। इट यूजुअली प्रेजेंट्स एट एज ऑफ मोर देन 50 ईयर्स एंड मेल्स आर मोर अफेक्टेड दैन फीमेल्स। द मेन फीचर्स ऑफ दिस डिजीज इज दैट देर शुड बी एटलीस्ट 2 weeks ऑफ और मोर ऑफ सिम्टम्स विथ प्रेजेंट विथ विच इज bilateral shoulder pain which radiates to upper arm or elbow, bilateral pelvic girdle pain. This pain worsens with improvement and also interferes with sleep. And there is a stiffness when the patient rises up in morning for about 45 minutes before there is easing out of the joints. Other features can be weight loss, fatigue and low grade fever, also upper arm tenderness. The differential diagnosis of this can be osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, or SLE, or myositis, or cervical spondylosis, or adhesive capsulitis, or hyper and hypothyroidism. This disease is a disease of extrusion, so we must rule out all these causes. If all these causes are not present or not causing this pain and stiffness, then we can say that this is due to polymyalgia rheumatica. The clinical features are the diagnosis is made by having different tests which can exclude all the differential diagnosis. For example, you can do ASR-CRP which can be raised, I think it's an inflammatory condition. For ruling out, you can do liver function test, you can do calcium test which can increase due to parathyroid hormone or in astomalacia. You can do TSH to check for thyroid, you can also do creatinine kinase to check for myositis, anti-CCP or rheumatoid factor to check for rheumatoid arthritis, or anti-nuclear antibodies to check for systemic lupus erythematosus. And if these are not present, then we can say that it is polymyalgia rheumatica. Management is mainly based on giving steroids, which is and the one of the most common steroids given is prednisolone, which is started at 15 mg dose, and it is checked whether there is an improvement of about 70-80% after 3-4 weeks. If it's not there, then we can rule out that this is not polymyalgia rheumatica. And after that, we slowly taper the dose after 3-4 weeks, and this takes about 2 years to be enough. If in between there is any flaring up, then we can always increase the dose or maintain the dose till the system subsides or there is an improvement. And but while being on steroids, we must also be aware of the side effects of long-term steroid treatment, and it can be osteoporosis or there is or gastric retention, for which we can give vitamin D calcium supplementation or proton pump inhibitors so that we can reduce the symptoms, or hypercalcemia, we can restrict the calorie intake so that there is not increased glucose level, and which can hamper with which may lead to deposition of glucose in the body.